Welcome back. Happy Monday. Hope your weekend was pleasant. I'm assuming mine will be, since I'm actually recording this before the weekend, but my weekends are usually pretty pleasant. I checked back on Friday's video, and Parsely Woods definitely was spelled correctly up until the moment that I drained that lake. And then after that level, it became Parsely, which is really weird. I have to assume that's just some sort of boneheaded mistake. I don't think they would do that on purpose. Oh, wow. I do not like the looks of that cloud. Let's see if I can fire this cloud to death. Nope. Oh, wow. It turns enemies into 10 coins. That might actually be of use to me. See if I can coax him. It. No, the lightning bolt. I just want to hit that bridge. Here's your meteorological lesson for the Wario games. Never trust a happy cloud. See, it's counterintuitive because in every other Mario game, or in every Mario game, a happy cloud is good. Unless there's a Latiku in it. Hey, that actually worked. Whereas in Mario games, what you want to watch out for is an angry sun. Happy clouds are usually pretty good, though. Although I guess, you know, if you can bend the happy cloud to do your bidding, it's pretty good in this game too. You just have to watch yourself a little bit. Aw, man. I'm gonna have to die now. I have 13 lives. Or get a 1-up. That would be pretty ace too. Heck yeah! I like the basket bird. I think someone in the comments called it a coin chicken, which is also pretty good, but I like Basket Bird a little bit better. Well, that was a miss. That was an old misky. It puts the enemy in the basket. There we go. Over 100 coins. I can rack up a few more if I want. Aw. The basket bird went off the screen and I lost it. I'll have to... There we go. Baby, I'm a rich man. Okay, bird. You're no longer of use to me. Sure. Huh, 10 coins. Pocket change. Those enemies didn't respawn, did they? Because if so, I'm totally abusing these basket birds again. Man, if I wanna stock up and abuse the system, this seems to be the place to do it. Or one of the places to do it. I could always just abuse save states, I guess, in the coin doubling game, but I'd rather not have to. Aw. Okay. So definitely no more enemy respawns here. I wouldn't keep doing that anyway, I just wanted to see how long the game would let me push it. Whoa. The place where I hit the checkpoint is in the same area. It's like everything's connected, man. We're all part of one big cosmic tree with water in it. Really wish I could kill these hedge horses. That's what I decided to call these things, since they're like a cross between a hedgehog and a seahorse. The hedge horse. Well, I guess I should probably go looking for this treasure, huh? Even if I am small. And I have the unlucky 13 lives. Hey, don't mind if I do. Unfortunately, I won't be able to cast Fireball while I'm holding onto this key, but I should be okay. Aw, respawn. That's not fair. I can't respawn. Well, I guess technically I can, but I have to sacrifice one of my precious lives. Hedge horses have an unlimited number of lives. I'll keep my dragon hat, thanks. Treasure? Yeah, treasure. I never really looked to see if there was anything else in these treasure areas. I guess it wouldn't make sense for there to be. Baseball mitt. Interesting. That's the second, well, I guess technically the third bit of sports-related memorabilia I got. Between the trophy, the football, or the hand egg, as one of my viewers called it. Which is a cheeky way of saying that, you know, for non-Americans, calling an oval-shaped thing that you mostly throw around a football is kind of weird. Since mostly, well, A, it's not ball-shaped, it's egg-shaped, and B, you don't interact with it primarily with your feet. You primarily use your hands. Alright, I have enough coins. I gotta do something about these 13 lives. That's not good for my outlook. I can probably... Let's try the B course again. I almost nailed it last time. I just screwed up a little bit because I misjudged the, Oh yeah. Heck yeah! Bomb that duck! This music is giving me the confidence I need to win. 2 for 2. Wink. Alright, don't get cocky, Duke. Hey. Wario is like the Fonz of the Mario universe. If this game had a jukebox in it, you could totally hit it to make it start working again. Aced the B course. What? 16 extra lives. That is like super lucky. That is luck plus 2. Luck nothing. Skill. Not dumb luck. Dumb skill. Alright. Still have my dragon hat. Have a lot of treasure, have a lot of coins. Feeling boss? Acting boss. And we're back on the murder train. Great. Well, at least we have some appropriate murder train music. I guess the reason this sounds more like a traditional Wario tune is that it kind of has like a ragtime kind of feel to it. You know, most of the music in Super Mario World was ragtime, or based on ragtime. If you've never seen it, you should look up the guy on YouTube who does the Super Mario World theme on the piano, and it is awesome. That is a great piece of music. Koji Kondo, you outdid yourself with that one. And the thing about that guy is, he's not even like a video game fan or anything. Someone gave him like sheet music of the Wario World, or Mario World, theme tune, And he just nails it because he's just a savant piano player. It's quite spectacular. And then he plays it in like double time. Man, that's cruel. Throwing him onto the train tracks. That has some 60s cartoon villain stuff right there. I guess it predates 60s cartoons. I was thinking of Snidely Whiplash because he was always tying women to train tracks, but I guess that was a parody of like old Asylum movies, I guess. Whereas I don't even bother with the tie. I bet there's a door inside one of these and I totally missed it. Guess I need to come back here with my dragon hat. Oh well. This wasn't a bullseye level, so the best thing it could have been was a treasure. Now see, why does it just stop auto-scrolling once I get to this point? The train's still moving. You know? Why, video games. Making zero sense since 1977. Or, you know, way before that, if you count the old oscilloscope games. Well, no, I guess computer space was like early 70s. That wasn't oscilloscope based. Man, talk about a game that doesn't make sense. Computer Space. That was an opaque-ass video game. Not that I've ever played it, but, you know, I've heard rumors. Alright, boss time. No secret levels. We haven't had a secret level in quite a while. So I assume this is the lake that I drained. Sure what it looks like. It seems to be similar to the underwater levels, but there's no water, of course. I guess I could futz around with that cloud a little bit to try to get some try to get some coins, but this is a pretty narrow passageway. Like there's not a whole lot of room to move around, so kind of wanna. Aw, I can't just hold it under the lightning bolt? I have to actually put him on the ground? Okay. Well, that wasn't that bad. Aw! Dang, I wasn't counting on that third lightning bolt. Oh wait, no, this isn't the drained lake. The drained lake was way down there. Huh. Or maybe I'm misinterpreting the map. I don't know. I wonder if the lightning bolts can kill those spike balls. Probably not. It'd be nice. Secret door? Nope. Secret door? Get away from me, Cloud. I'm looking for secret doors. Nope. Yeah. Hearts? Yep. Because I already had the horns. Hey, here we go. Dang, three up. That's pretty good. The block sure looks sore after I hit it, though. I guess all the blocks look sore after you hit them, but the big one, especially, it looks extra sore. Hey! I do not need the likes of you, Spikey. Aw, you butthole. Oh well. At least I have a big There. I tried to go down in this hole so I could duck the spiky ball, but it did not work. Hold on. Aw. Nope. Oh well. Hey! Taste the wrath of my fire! Yeah! Don't worry, I was just kidding. Of course I know that fire doesn't do damage to lightning. Now if that was an ice cloud, then I'd be in business. No, you don't. I can sort of lure this thing where I wanted to start shooting the lightning bolts out to give me some room to move. That's good. I just have to move out of the way when it starts flashing. I'll stick with dragon, thank you very much. Oh hey, boss time. Oh, it's a ghost. Hey. That's a big ghost of me. Aw, what? It froze me. Okay, so I have to throw the ghosts back at it, I guess. The small ghosts. I wonder why coins turn into the ghosts, and why the tombstone looks like a coin. Very weird metaphysical stuff going on in this game. Jeez! Aw. Well, I thought I had to wait for it to stop flashing before I could hit it, but it seemed like it was always flashing, so I don't know what the deal is. I lost all those coins. Oh well. At least it's a boss level, so I will presumably get a bunch of coins at the end of this level to make up for what I lost. And the checkpoint is kind of far back there. Hey, nice. Yeah, I guess I'll stick with the fire. I don't see any reason not to. Other than the obnoxiously loud noise that it makes. I mean, I checked the video and it sounded fine in the video. I mean, it sounded a little loud, but not intolerably loud. But man, in my headphones, that fire. I mean, I can't even hear myself talk when I activate the fire. So, if I start talking louder while I'm spitting fire out of my hat, then I apologize. It's to compensate for not being able to hear myself. Alright, ghost. I'm going to learn your secrets. What's this a ghost of? Alright, so fire does not seem to hurt this thing. Yeah, so that seems to be the only way I can affect it. I mean, it has like floppy dog ears, so is it a ghost dog? Is it a samurai? And what's it carrying? Is that like a coin purse? Actually, that would make sense, since it is throwing coins at me. You jerk. Oh, well, at least it doesn't freeze you for that long. No! Yes! I eat ghosts for breakfast. Ghosts and spiders. Well, I don't eat the spiders for breakfast per se. They just kind of end up in my mouth somehow. I don't know what the deal is. 182. I have enough lives. I'm good. I was going to play the money making game, but I don't know. I'd rather not. So from what I understand, to get the best ending, you either need 99,999 coins, or you need X number of coins and X number of treasures. So you don't need all of the coins or all the treasures to get the best ending, I don't think. You just need some good combination of the two. So I'm not really sure how I'm doing at this point. I guess I'll have to wait until the end to see what ending I get. Uh-oh. This looks like a last level. Boy, if you thought the Parsely Woods were intimidating, wait until Syrup Castle. That is big ol' stack of death. So tune in tomorrow to see what this level's like. I guess I can go in, give you a little preview. Okay, never mind. I will see you guys tomorrow. I'm Duke of the Bum. Goodbye.